So let's take a look at this problem, which is the skyscraper problem. So here's what it says. It says, you're in an interview for a job with two other interns. This job is for a window washing company that specializes in washing skyscraper windows. You are to create a bill for a skyscraper that is 14 stories tall and has 11 windows on each of the four sides of the building on every floor. Now, I'm going to stop there for just a second to kind of give us a picture of what that looks like. So imagine this is our building. We're saying that this building is 14 stories tall. That means it has 14 floors. So this is a pretty good representation of that. So we're going to say 1 floor, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so forth until we get up to 14. All right? Now, it also says that this building has four sides, which it would, and it's telling us that on each floor, there are 11 windows on each side. So we're saying 11, I'm just going to put W for windows. On this side, there would be 11 windows. On this side, there would be 11 windows on the back, and there would be 11 windows on the other side as well. And that's true for every single floor. So the bottom floor would have 11 windows on each side. All the way up to the 14th floor would have 11 windows on each side. All right, let's read the rest. So it says, the company charges $2 per window for the first floor, $3.50 per window for the second floor, $5 per window for the third floor, and it continues. And we hopefully notice a pattern there. The amount of money that will be charged for this job must be accurate and accompanied by a clear explanation that the manager of the skyscraper will understand. What will be the total? What will the cost be in total for the whole building, all 14 floors? Now, let's go back and see what else we know here. We know that this building is a total of 14 floors. I showed you the first eight there, all the way up to floor number 14. And we also know that each side of this building has 11 windows. And the last thing that it just told us there right at the end was it told us the cost of a couple of the floors. It told us, for instance, that the first floor costs $2. It said the second floor, each window is $3.50. The third floor, each window is $5, and so forth. And hopefully we kind of notice a pattern here. Now, you may notice that it's increasing in cost each time we go up a floor. That's because it's going to be a little harder to wash the windows as you get higher and higher and higher up into our skyscraper. Now, knowing this, we can figure out the cost of each floor. The first thing I want you to really think about is if there are 11 windows on each side of the building, how many windows would there be on each floor? So in other words, we have 11 on one side, and 11 on another side, and 11 on another side, and 11 on another side. How many total windows is that going to be on each floor? Because remember, that's true for every single floor. So let's look at the first one. Let's look at the first floor together. The first floor, if there's 11, 11, 11, and 11, I can either do 11 plus 11 plus 11 plus 11, which is 44, or I could do 11 times 4, which is 44. That tells me that there are 44 windows on the first floor. So a total of 44 windows on the first floor. And I know that each of those windows is $2. So for floor number one, first floor, I know that I'm just going to do 44 windows times $2, which is going to give me a total of $88 for the first floor. Now, each floor going up is going to cost more and more money. Our question here, if we go back to our question, is how much is it going to cost in total for the whole building? And the whole building, remember, is all 14 floors up to the very top. Now, the other thing that we're going to have to think about is you're going to notice that the cost per floor is going up. But by how much is it going up? Can we find a pattern there It's going to tell us the cost of each floor as we're going up. Now, I will tell you, there's a long way to do this problem, and there's a much shorter way to do this problem. So I want you to think about this. I want you to see if we can find any way to solve the problem. And then after you finish, think about, can I find a quicker way to solve this problem? Is it possible to do it in a quicker way? And as you go to fill out your Google form for today, I did post the solution eventually in that. So after you've solved the problem and you input your solution there, I'm going to give you the solution so you'll know what to look for. I really, really am looking forward to looking at your work for today's lesson. So make sure that you include your work in an email today, because I really want to look to see what you guys do. This is really using a lot of the skills that we've been learning, and it's really going to make you think today. So I really want to see what it is that you're doing. And make sure that you ask if you have any questions. All right, good luck, guys.